Hi, I'm Rich with insideHPC. We're here at REMS France at the LAD14 conference, and I'm here with Gabriele. How are you doing?
Oh, fine. Thanks.
Great. Well, thanks for coming on. You know, I want to ask you about this new connector you have for Hadoop. How did this come about?
Yeah, so we released two software for Hadoop. One is the Hadoop adapter for Lustre that give you the possibility to run Hadoop job on top of Lustre without any HDFS framework. And another connector is the HPC adapter for MapReduce that give you the possibility to integrate in any existing scheduler MapReduce job.
Okay, well, let's start with the first one. Why would I want to connect a Lustre to Hadoop? Why not just use HDFS?
Because this is a request from our customer that want to integrate Lustre in Hadoop in an existing Lustre cluster. And after that, we saw several enterprise customers that want to put in production their Hadoop project, and the return of investment on a 3x replication file system is very bad, because you have only 25% of the raw capacity of your multi-petabyte file system with 3x replication. With Lustre, you can achieve more return of investment and the full speed of an InfiniBand native file system. So there are several reasons why enterprise customer and already HPC labs is looking with interest with this software.
Okay, so what kind of performance difference could I expect, or what have you seen out there between the difference between Lustre and HDFS on a deployment?
It's difficult to say, because you can measure with HDFS is not a POSIX file system. So you can't use IOR or the existing benchmark for IO, and you can measure this performance. So is something that you have to do case by case. But with the full bandwidth that you can have from InfiniBand, you can take a lot of advantage of, from Lustre compared to HDFS that is designed for the cloud, not more for an environment with low latency, high-speed networks.
Okay, so Lustre being the fastest file system in the world, adding that to a Hadoop kind of MapReduce was the second one you mentioned. Right. What about the other things, such as, you know, we run Spark and Yarn and all these other, does that come to play here?
Yes, the first version of the connector only support MapReduce job. Now in the next version that we will unveil during the next supercomputer, we will support Hive and HBase, Pig and Moat at least, and we have plan to support to also support Spark. But as you know, Intel has done a good investment in Cloudera, so we are aligned with the roadmap of Cloudera in order to support Spark and this kind of. Hadoop is a very huge ecosystem, so a technology like, for example, Mahout, that until the latest version of Hadoop is based on MapReduce, now is moving to Spark. So it's a very fast file system, ecosystem, and it's not easy to follow, but we try to do that.
Okay. Well, coming from Italy, you know, you've dealt with a lot of enterprise customers, whereas a lot of us HPC guys have stayed in the research area. Is this exciting for you to see these two worlds coming together?
Yes, it's very exciting, because I saw that many enterprise customers are looking for HPC style workload, and something is becoming to mix together these two environments. But it's also a challenge for us, because we have to push into Lustre enterprise-ready functionality. And Intel is doing that, because we are in plan to implement several enterprise features in our distribution of Lustre.